Seal cracks and splinters with the ultimate do-over for wood and concrete. Don't replace, resurface. Behr Premium Deck Over, exclusively at the Home Depot.
In the nation, we know how you feel about your car. So when coverage really counts, you can count on Nationwide. Because what's precious to you is precious to us. Just another way we put members first. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
It's a golden opportunity to discover the exhilaration of efficiency. Come into the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event for some of the best offers of the year on our entire hybrid lineup for a limited time. This is the pursuit of perfection.
Away. Okay. Is the smell of salt in the air. It's the sound a seashell makes. Away is a place that's beyond your imagination, yet well within your means. Find your Away. For a dealer in the RV that's right for you, visit GoRVing.com.
Are you a man over 40 and feeling tired, losing muscle, have less romantic drive? Then you need Ageless Male, with an ingredient clinically shown to increase free testosterone levels. Ageless Male is now available at these fine retailers.
Monday on AMHQ.
You're about to see something you have never seen on television before.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
Let's talk about that.
Let's lift the base of this and talk a little bit about tornadoes.
That's pretty impressive. Let me show you why.
We'll tell you about it coming up.
Iniki is the most destructive hurricane on record to strike Hawaii, inflicting nearly $2 billion in damage.
Iniki teaches us that, you know, we're not safe from hurricanes here in Hawaii. We may not get them very often hitting the islands, but the instant we let our guard down is when we're going to get burned.
One bright spot in Iniki's wake is the wedding of Ed and Donna Kanoi.
Ed, do you have this woman to be your wife?
I will.
People just really needed something to lift their spirits. And the wedding gave them that.
Please kiss your bride.
It was a magical moment, it really was.
It wasn't the dream that I had planned originally, but it was better than anything I ever could have planned.
For the Weather Channel, I'm meteorologist Jim Cantore.
Yeah, oh my gosh, go.
Hey, Larry, we need
go
to go.
Go now, go.
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 The Great Escape, frantic moments for a family forced to flee from a fast-moving wildfire, and yes, it was all captured on video. This morning, we're talking live to that family about their narrow escape.
And right at the height of summer vacation, it's going to be a weekend washout across Florida. You're going to be seeing and hearing a lot of rain. Up next, we're timing it all out and what effect it will have on your plans.
And you know what? We've got a close eye in the tropics. The mystery may or may not be impacting us in the next few days. Guys, stay tuned for that. Some of the models suggest there'll be some development. Plus, you've seen, Kate, you've seen some of these stories, haven't you?
Some of these stories of kids being left in hot cars.
That's horrible.
Yeah, but would you know what to do if you found a child left in a hot car on a summer's day? These, the steps that you can take straight ahead. Good morning. Welcome to AMHQ Weekend. It's Saturday, July the 25th. I'm Kate Parker. We've got Reynolds Wolf out today, but Jen Carfagno filling in.
Good to be here, guys. And of course, we've got Dr. Postel.
Yes, you know, there is something kind of brewing in the tropics, and it's kind of close to home. We'll talk about that. But you know what? First, Florida is going to have a lot more rain today, Kate.
Oh, yeah. Take a look at this video. Right into St. Augustine. Heavy rain on tap for the East Coast again today. Nearly 3 inches of rain fell in less than an hour in St. Augustine yesterday. Talk about a heavy rainfall rate. Holy camoly. And we had 40 mile an hour wind gusts. We did get a lot of rain. It did flood the roads, especially in low-lying areas. Fortunately, it's sand there, so it drains pretty quickly.
Yeah, but it happens so fast, right? So you get just a mess. And look, I think someone's waiting to walk down those stairs and like, nope, I'm not going.
Yeah, I see
little toes there at the end.
I think that's as far as I'll go there.
Yep.
Let's take a look at your Saturday snapshot and give you an idea of what all we've got brewing today, because it's not just the storms in Florida. We've got a lot of heat across the South, Jen. This is intense.
All right, and the heat we've really building, especially in parts of Oklahoma and down into Texas. Turnaround don't melt is one of the hashtags I saw trending up. And so that's going to be the heat, a big story. But of course, north of that, we'll see some storms and we could see severe weather again today as well.
Out west, we've got a cloudy and cool forecast for the Pacific Northwest after so much heat. So this is kind of a change of pace here. But we do need to get started with the South, because this is really where we've got a lot of those possibly flooding thunderstorms in the forecast.
Yeah, we're going to see again a full day's worth of showers and storms, not just a few in the afternoon. And one spot is Tampa, where one driver who had a stormy journey through the streets of Tampa on Friday, this is what he saw. So this is how much rain fell during the commute. Reports of some heavy flooding actually around the holiday Florida area. There was reports of water rising up to the hoods of some cars, and ended up with about 2 inches of rain officially last night. But do you know how it is? Some spots locally got more, and we are expecting more right through Monday. The forecast is a wet one for Tampa and really for a lot of folks down here in the Sunshine State, especially down in the peninsula. Let's take a look at things for you today. Chance of storms out there, especially in the morning. Some of those storms could bring some heavy rain. I'll show you why in a moment. But then we keep it in the forecast right through the day today and into the early evening. We'll see storms. The radar even active this morning. A lot of times this afternoon activity right in Florida, but we've got thunderstorms offshore for now, a little bit in South Florida, not too far from Naples this morning. We are going to be watching for Fort Myers as well. I'm sure you're seeing some of those clouds in the distance now. If you're heading out to the beach maybe to catch the sunrise, you're going to be seeing those storm clouds out there. Some of them do have some lightning. Now, it's typical Florida weather here. It is hot. It is going to be humid today, and that's going to lead to some thunderstorms that will bring some heavy rain chances. We've got this front, this boundary, and this boundary is going to be all we're talking about when it comes to different angles of the weather this weekend. It's going to mean that, yes, we say stormy here across portions of Florida. It could have some tropical implications, which we'll get to with Postel in just a minute. It could actually help us out a bit with the drought. You know, we need rain, especially on the East Coast and in the Southeast Coast in particular. We need about 18 inches of rain to actually end the drought here. Not saying we're going to get that out of this, but we could get some decent downpours to help out with the drought situation. We put our future radar here on the map, and we'll show you what it looks like. Lunchtime Tampa. I mean, you're not outside today. Your run down Bayshore Boulevard, probably not happening with that threat of storms. And even over there towards Daytona and up towards Jacksonville, we got showers and thunderstorm chances right through today. And it continues through the weekend. So Greg and Kate, let's talk about the tropical concerns with this.
Yeah, you know, you get these things stalled out. This is kind of that time of year where we, this time of year, we're typically looking a little farther out in the Atlantic, but because of the setup, we're looking close to home with tropical development.
Doesn't it seem like we've done that a few times already this year, where we've looked kind of close to our shores and looked for development there? That's kind of the setup over the next couple of days. And let's look at this map here. This is an area to watch over the next 5 days. In fact, the Hurricane Center has a 20% chance of development roughly in this area during that period. So off the east coast, there could be some spin-ups, and it's likely going to happen along or very near these fronts that are there. Right. And fronts are really good at creating storms and some potential for development.
Yeah, those homegrown storms, you know, because if we're looking way out in the Atlantic, it's a totally different story than these things that are very close to the coast.
Yep.
And can change your forecast very quickly.
Yeah, and the reason why the fronts are important to track is, one, they have a lot of thunderstorms typically with them. And two, they've got sort of a spin already attached to them. So when you have thunderstorms and spin, you put that in the tropics,
right,
that can spell trouble. And so what we've got here, I shaded here in this color, is the sort of low-level circulation that is accompanying these fronts. And I'm going to go through hour by hour and show you how one of these fronts, the cold front, kind of slides down, kind of stalls out and hangs out for days. This is just Monday, but it's going to be there Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, with an area of spin along that zone. And again, we'll have thunderstorms, we'll have that broad circulation, Kate, and the models have been for a couple of days trying to spin up something along that boundary. So we have to keep a close eye on that area where the waters are exceptionally warm as well.
Okay, we're going to talk about impacts and what that could possibly mean coming up. First, we've got to send it back over to Jen.
All right, guys, so coming up this morning on AMHQ Weekend, we're just getting started on the Saturday morning, including a hot, steamy day for nearly 12 million Americans across 8 states. We're talking Texas to Missouri. Plus, the risk of hail, damaging winds, and isolated tornadoes from Kansas to Ohio. We're timing out the storms there, and we'll show you the biggest impacts for today.
Zantac heartburn alert! Stop! Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Brought to you by Zantac.
Huge savings on oil changes are in store this week only at Pep Boys. We're talking $17.99 for a conventional oil change, or upgrade to a Castrol or Pennzoil full synthetic oil change for $39.99 with coupon. Trust the boys to get you there.
It's easy to buy insurance and forget about it, but the more you learn about your coverage, the more gaps you may find.
Like how you thought you were covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
But you're not even covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
Or how you may be covered for this, but not for something like this. Talk to farmers and see what gaps could be hiding in your coverage.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
A different treatment for every itch? Clean out your cabinet. Blue Emu Anti-Itch Cream has the strongest form of hydrocortisone available without a prescription. And it's the only brand with Cord Emu Complex. New Blue Emu with hydrocortisone. One cream, every itch.
Take any color on a virtual test drive with the Project Color app. Part of a new color experience from the Home Depot. In hand, online, and at the store. Bare Ultra Interior, just $29.98 a gallon. Download the Project Color app. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
It's an Olive Garden first, but it won't last long. Create your own tour of Italy starting at $12.99. Choose three of our nine most loved dishes to enjoy on one plate. Serve with salad and breadsticks. Hurry in to create your tour at Olive Garden.
Monday morning, sunscreen's a must for this time of year. Doris Day joining us with the sunscreen 101 you need before you're in the sun. Wake up with Al Monday morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 74, winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 88, chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
Real local.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas.
Real accurate.
This one's going to have some precipitation with it.
Real experts.
Wow, that's the leading edge of the thunderstorm.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel.
Keep the Weather Channel on.
We're at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
Hey, hey, hope you have that coffee. Welcome back to AMHQ Weekend. Look at this. This little self-contained, beautiful show over the skies with Landon late last night. Lightning bolts, you know, they stayed cloud to cloud. Not too much CG going on. A few isolated storms. It was actually just this one storm. Lone Ranger out there hanging out outside the city. But it really caused quite the view, Jen.
I loved
beautiful.
It.
Beautiful.
Do you see the little, that Peleus cloud at the top?
Yes, I love that.
Cap cloud.
Okay, so those form whenever you have really fast moving upward motion of air. And, you know, you hit that layer of cooler air.
Yeah.
And I love them. They're like little hats on the thunderstorm.
This was the only show in town. It got everyone's attention. There were so many tweets and Facebook posts about this one in the Atlanta area. So another city that has a chance of seeing this, although maybe a lot more of it, is Indianapolis. Right now, things are quiet out there. Temperature 69 degrees. What a great week we had, right? things are going to change, Indy. We've got temperatures heating up. We've got dew points coming up. We've got the risk of thunderstorms back in the area. So we're going to keep an eye on things for you out there, looking for possible severe weather in parts of the plains in the Midwest. All right, so Indianapolis Indians tonight, first pitch 7:05 at Victory Field, Louisville in town. We're going to take a look at timing out when storms are going to be in the area. This morning, we've got a couple of clusters of storms, one now moving east of Omaha. Kind of, you see the boundary, you sort of see, you can guess where the boundary is by watching where we're watching these thunderstorms continue to roll right along. Some rain for you right now on I-35 as you get down from Iowa into Missouri. We got some rain as well on I-70, but some heavier bouts on either side, north and south of it here, right going through Missouri. St. Louis, not yet, but we're going to keep an eye on your weather this morning as well, because you could get a few showers at least this morning. So there's the boundary. We got some upper level energy, and that jet stream energy is going to be, I think, one of the big instigators for some of these severe weather threats that we see today. In general, the strongest energy is farther north, but we will see some disturbances out there that sort of enhance the threat for severe weather. A front moves in over the weekend as well, and this is going to be another thing that pushes the air up, gets it rising, gets storm clouds building, and we will see that risk of thunderstorms. So when we put it all together, this is what it's going to mean for your weekend plans. We've got some storms out there already this morning in Iowa, Missouri. We'll see that go away, but then we'll see a few more spotty showers and thunderstorms develop. Chicago, we're talking about you later tonight. Indy, we're talking about you overnight. There could be some showers and storms in this area. Same thing in Columbus, sort of an I-70 corridor that we're looking at, and even back towards St. Louis as well. Risk for severe weather all in this red zone. It does include Indianapolis. It includes Detroit. Chicago, you're on the northern edge of it, but in it, and also looking at St. Louis and Kansas City, Omaha, North Platte, all cities that need to have their weather radios ready today. If you have outside plans, keep a close watch on that sky. When the clouds start getting dark, you might want to move everything inside. All right, Peoria, Illinois, you are also in the red zone for today. We've got the risk of thunderstorms continuing into the overnight, and actually tomorrow we're still going to see the chance of storms around. The pattern really not changing that much. Now here temperatures are going to be in the mid-80s. It's going to be humid, but the heat and the humidity, Kate, just a little further south.
Yeah, really holding on tight here in KC Mo. That's where we're taking a look right now live. You know, on a Saturday morning, I got to tell you, that rush hour traffic just backed up. Ooh, not a car to see. Let's talk about what your car is going to be doing. You're going to be hopping in it. You're going to be cranking the AC. You're going to be avoiding the, you know, the seatbelts, because those little metal things, they can brand you. Now, the Royals are hosting the Astros tonight out of the Big K. First pitch at 7:10. Temperature still hovering in the 90s then. Gotta tell you what. Nothing better than a game at the K. It's a really cool spot if you've never been. Let's talk about Kansas City, because your average high is 89 degrees. You're hanging out way above it over the next few days, and by Tuesday, you're flirting with the triple digits for your high temperature, and that does not include your heat index. So that's not including your humidity levels, your dew point, which is excessively high this time of year, especially in the Midwest. Take a look at what we've got with these excessive heat warnings. They extend across much of Oklahoma, into Kansas, and into portions of Missouri. We've also got an excessive heat warning for Memphis today. This is why. The jet hanging out to the north, and it's basically just keeping that heat held in right over the southern states. And look at this. This is the dew points that we're looking at here. So this is where we're going to see really high humidity on top of that. That's going to be from the soil moisture and just moisture in general in the atmosphere, especially near those cornfields. That's where we get the highest dew points, and it is just unbearable. Houston, look at this. Okay, so your temperature may be 81 degrees at 9 o'clock this morning. It's pretty early to be that warm, but your dew point's going to be 77, which means at 9 o'clock this morning, it's going to feel like nearly 90 degrees. That's how fast that heat is really going to crank up. Look at this. By 3 o'clock this afternoon, we get up to 96 degrees for an air temperature, but with a 68 degree dew point, that means it's going to feel like 104 degrees. So you may not be hitting the triple digits today in Houston, but you certainly are going to feel like it. You're going to be lingering right there in those triple digits. Look at this. This afternoon, 109 in Little Rock is what it'll feel like. Shreveport, 108. Dallas, Texas, Grapevine, Texas, my hometown, 104.
Ugh, it is brutal, and it lasts too, not just today, but through the weekend into next week. Now, coming up ahead on AMHQ weekend, crews are bracing for a fresh run of raging wildfires burning across three states, sending tourists and campers fleeing. We're going to hear from one family escaping as flames closed in.
Defiance is in our bones. New Citracal Pearls. Delicious berries and cream. Soft, chewable, calcium plus vitamin D. Only from Citracal.
amore.
Subito. No!
The all-new Fiat 500X crossover, featuring an available Uconnect system with a 6.5-inch touchscreen and available all-wheel drive. Well-rounded, has never looked so sharp.
Why do you think the ripples make a difference?
Grabs more?
It's the clean ripple texture. Now, do you feel so clean that you would go commando?
Wait a... How do you feel?
Awesome. Cottonelle has clean ripple texture, so you're clean enough to go commando.
This is good, Mom.
Good? It's delicious. And this new kibble blend is so healthy.
Thank you.
No, Nancy. Thank you. Kibbles and bits, because every bit matters.
Bop, 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 bop.
Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ, the whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning, because we're all watching history happen together.
Miracles happen daily in Delray at Milagro Center. We help enrich the lives of local children and teens through art education, academic support, and mentoring. And now you can be part of the miracle. Whether you become a mentor, teach an art or music class, organize a fundraiser, or simply make a donation, you'll be making an extraordinary difference in the life of a child. To find out how you can help Milagro Center, call 561-279-2970 or visit milagrocenter.org.
It's amazing what you can do with a click these days. Just click to make any night family movie night. Just click to order your favorite dinner. And now, just click to save up to $250 a year on your energy bill. With FPL's online home energy survey, it's now easier to fast forward to personalized savings. Go to fpl.com/easy-to-save to take the survey and make your bill even lower.
Real local.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas.
Real accurate.
This affects you.
Real experts.
Wow, that's the leading edge of the thunderstorm.
Only the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 74, winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 88, chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Today marks 5 days since a massive wildfire started raging in Glacier National Park. It already burned 4,000 acres while chasing campers and tourists out of campsites, with one family right in the thick of it as flames raced near their car.
Yeah, oh my gosh, go.
Okay, Larry, we need
go
to go.
Go now, go.
Go.
Go. Okay. Like, yeah, no, go. Fast, Dad, go. Holy crap, Dad, go.
You know, a lot of times we see these fires from above and you don't get the perspective of just how massive they are, but you get it here. Those flames reaching above those giant trees. Now the fire forcing the closure of the main road into the eastern half of the park, which gets over 2 million visitors a year. This fire, just one of several chewing through the bone dry west. NBC's Hallie Jackson has more.
A dangerous new battle is unfolding high above the front lines.
We're trying to get the drone thing situated.
Against drones interfering with aircraft, like at this California wildfire, where frustrated dispatchers tried to navigate around five of them.
I got aircraft all over the place and can't do anything with it.
For 26 crucial minutes with no air support, cars burned. From this perspective, it's clear why fire crews don't want drones around.
During an air attack, the choppers, the planes are constantly coordinating to support the ground crews. Having a hobby drone flying around could be dangerous or even deadly.
If you have a drone in the sky and we ground aircraft, unfortunately, homes can be destroyed, lives can be lost, and firefighters can be killed.
This year, drone incidents reported nationwide are prompting a flurry of proposed laws to crack down on people who fly them, collecting dramatic footage, like this video posted by someone who says he checked with fire crews first, calling himself the drone doctor. His real name's Tony Bauer. He wants his fellow drone pilots to be responsible.
All it takes is one bad apple to sensationalize things and make all drones appear to be bad. It's a tool. If you use the tool correctly, it can be used for a lot of good.
Drones can fly where manned aircraft cannot, like in thick smoke or at night. Researchers in Alaska are testing the technology at wildfires there using infrared to map hotspots.
A decade from now, it'll be on every fire truck, without question.
But for now, the danger from drones, yet another threat on the fire line. Hallie Jackson, NBC News, Winters, California.
Okay, so coming up in just a little bit on AMHQ Weekend, we're going to talk live with the family who escaped those flames in Glacier National Park, their harrowing experience, and how they got out. Let's talk about the drought in the West, because this is just relentless. Doesn't it seem like it's never ending? Well, it's certainly not ending anytime soon. Exceptional drought at 32% for the state of California. Really tremendous. Now, if you take a look at this, that was at on January 1st that we saw that. Now, if you fast forward, look how we see no improvement here. We're now at 46% exceptional drought. So really remarkable there. Okay, so this is how much rain we would need over the course of 6 months to end the drought. We would need 12 to 16 inches in Central California. In Southern California along the coast, we need about a foot. In Northern California, though, we would need 20 inches, nearly 2 feet of rain. There is some good news. It looks like later this year we might get a little bit better set up for some rain in the forecast. But look at this. This is the chance that you're going to end the drought. In Central California, 0 to 8% chance. So we're saying there is a chance, but it's not a very good one, Jen.
Well, and you look in that six-month time frame, and Kate, you can't go anywhere not hear about El Nino, right, and the strength of it, and hopefully the influence that we're going to get from it in the West. But that influence is normally seen in the winter months, so we're not going to get, you know, a huge signal, I think, in the short term. But we can look for subtleties out there to get us maybe some rain in parts of the Northwest. You know, we are in a drought, too, in parts of Washington and Oregon, and so we could use rain as well. We might get some. You can see something on the water vapor. You see this sort of dip, and that's going to bring in some moisture, at the very least bring in some clouds and cool us down a little bit. We take a look at the forecast and the current conditions out there. Right now, starting with temperatures in the 60s, a lot of dry conditions over the West, as you would expect, right? This is our dry season. We look over the next 3 days, and we will see some chances of rain in Seattle and Portland. Temperatures will be in the 70s. Meanwhile, we're looking at temperatures in the 80s down across LA, and as you get you into tomorrow as well, heating up a bit, Salt Lake City, 96, Albuquerque in the mid-90s. But the Northwest, we keep the chance for some showers around. So this is the pattern change that we're going to see Monday as well. We'll see that move into parts of Idaho and Montana, bring some rain there. We'll see if we can get some rain into Glacier National Park, but to help with the fire situation. But Kate, what we don't need is lightning, right?
Right. And especially with those elevated thunderstorms, yeah, you get the lightning and not a lot of the rain.
It's a fine line. Is it helpful or not?
Okay, well, it's a soggy mess in the Sunshine State. Parts of Florida could get up to 8 inches of rain this weekend. We have the latest forecast.
And a typhoon is bearing down on South Korea and Japan. We're going to check out the latest in the tropics.
And it's a great morning here on AMHQ Weekend. We're going to be taking a look at some of your viewer pictures, but we want you to send them in. Tweet at us, at AMHQ. We'd love to share them.
This program brought to you by CITGO. Learn about CITGO Coastal Restoration at CITGOCaringForOurCoast.com.
Introducing the first ever gummy multivitamin from Centrum. A complete and tasty new way to support your energy, immunity, and metabolism like never before. Centrum Multigummies. See gummies in a whole new light.
You owned your car for 4 years. You named it Brad.
You loved Brad, and then you totaled him. You two had been through everything together. Two boyfriends, three jobs. You're like, nothing can replace Brad. Then Liberty Mutual calls, and you break into your happy dance.
If you sign up for Better Car Replacement, we'll pay for a car that's a model year newer with 15,000 fewer miles than your old one. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
A little prep goes a long way with Scotch-Blue Painter's Tape. The one with 3M adhesive technology for less paint bleed-through and amazing results so you can forget about the redo. Pull off a better paint job with Scotch-Blue Painter's Tape.
You're my buddy, my pal, my friend. It will be that way until the end. And wherever you go, I want you.
Making the most out of every mile. You're my buddy. That's why I got a Subaru Impreza.
Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
Monday on AMHQ.
You're about to see something you have never seen on television before.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
Let's talk about that.
Let's lift the face of this and talk a little bit about tornadoes.
That's pretty impressive. Let me show you why.
We'll tell you about it coming up.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Real local.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas.
Real accurate.
This affects you.
Real experts.
Wow, that's the leading edge of the thunderstorm.
Only the Weather Channel.
Hey, happy Saturday to you. I don't know what you're up so early doing, but we're glad that you're with us.
I love getting up early on the weekends. I do. You have the whole day to
yourself. If you tell me you like getting up at 12:30 in the morning to be here, I will say.
That's a little early.
Okay, see, our wake-up call is a little bit early, but we're glad that you're awake.
Welcome to AMHQ Weekends.
All right, so I'm in for Reynolds Wolf today. I'm Jen Carfagna. We've got Greg Postel and Kate Parker here. I'm looking at a lot of active weather in Florida. So you might be early thinking you want to catch the sunrise, get that first walk on the beach, get your fishing pole set up. Maybe not so much.
Well, now's the time to do it. If you're going to try and get out there, I think we're going to see things look a little bit worse out there as the day goes on. But the tropics, this is all tied in, right?
Are they heating up, right? I mean, this year we've already seen a couple of developments close in to the shoreline of the U.S. Is this week upcoming going to show another one? See that front right there? See those clouds, those thunderstorms? There's a slight chance of development along that area in the next few days, and we'll talk much more about that. 50 past the hour and also at the top of the hour.
Whoa.
How about that?
Interesting.
creepy times in the tropics.
Very creepy. Here's your Saturday snapshot. You know, we've got this risk of severe weather in the northern plains. This is going to continue again today. This swath of possibly some large hail, some damaging winds, even an isolated tornado.
This is the season. You know, storm chasers go north. They go up to Canada this time of year, and this is where we normally see active weather this time.
You know what I saw a couple days ago? It was yesterday. Even I think it was on the map, Kansas City's dew point was 80 degrees. So on the south side of that frontal zone and the air that's going to be feeding the severe weather, is very humid, and it's going to be pretty unstable today, and hot.
Temperatures are going to be in the 90s, mm-hmm. with dew points that high. Very uncomfortable, and actually kind of dangerous, too.
Right. Not a great weekend for the Sunshine State, though.
No, we've got much of northern and central Florida that are going to see the heavy rain. And actually, on the west coast, their peninsula around Tampa, we could get 5 to 8 inches of rain. We've already had a lot of rain. Take a look at this, where you can see too much rain filling up the streets, causing some flooding. And you know, if you live here, you know how it is. It happens quickly, you get some flooding, but then it goes away quickly too, thanks to the sandy soil. Still a pain to deal with though when it's happening. So I'm gonna try and time it out for you so you can make your plans for today. Oh, you're gonna hear that rain pounding your rooftop before you know it. So let's take a look at what's going on in Tampa forecast-wise. This morning, some showers and storms, some heavy at times, and we keep that chance all the way into the evening. So it's not just an afternoon pop-up shower kind of thing. And you can see the radar already is very active. Tampa, here we go, north of town, right around maybe the Hudson area. We're gonna be getting some showers out there to start your day. And that trend is gonna be with us through the day today as well. Let's take a closer view down around Fort Myers, where now south of there, you can see a couple of showers starting to make their way onshore. A lot of lightning out in the distance as well, and you're probably getting quite the view if you're out there on the beaches this morning. Let's take a look at what's going on today as we see the showers right now, a couple right around the Mobile area. There's going to be a whole lot more. I mean, we're looking at a tough pattern for us with a lot of high humidity, very typical summertime Florida humidity. That's all across the southeast. But where we have this front, it's going to enhance the chance for showers and thunderstorms. So regardless of the tropics that we're going to talk about in just 2 seconds. But regardless of that, it will be very wet today with showers and storms throughout the peninsula all the way down into South Florida. So, Greg and Kate, what do you guys think about this? I mean, this front is just a typical thing to watch this time of year. It can sometimes spin up tropical development.
Yeah, especially when you have those warm waters that are hanging out along the Gulf Stream and, you know, those warm Atlantic waters, warm Gulf waters, and then you put some spin on top of it. Pretty easy, right?
Yeah, it can happen. It's happened before, and there's a chance it'll happen again. We'll talk about that a little bit later. But you know what also we have a chance at today is some severe weather in the northern plains.
Whole different story.
Whole different story. Completely unrelated front here, but Kansas City, Omaha, North Platte, maybe even Chicago. Keep an eye to the skies. There could be some severe weather today. The primary hazards would be large hail and high winds. Can't rule out the possibility of a tornado, though the odds of a tornado are not super high. But look at some of these storms across the region right now. Kate, you see this? Look at the outflow boundary. Jen, look.
Ooh,
you see these things are going in different directions. We've got some outflow boundaries from that storm.
You've got this one there.
Yeah.
And you've got a little flash flooding there near Jeff City.
And some flash flooding.
Slide and new storms.
Yeah, we could have some new storms. Exactly right in that area. And so their boundaries are laid out, and the sort of the atmosphere is going to be primed later on today. You can see in the last 6 hours that we're sort of developing this what's called ring of fire right in there, and that is around a hot ridge right out in here across the southern plains. So this is the area to watch today along a stationary boundary. Some unstable air later on today. It's going to be feeding more development. So we'll have a break for a while, but then Kate, later on this afternoon and evening, watch out.
Yeah, that energy that's left behind, like we were just talking about. Look at that. This evening, right along I-70.
Right.
Show me state.
That's right. This is the ring of fire again. This is now 1 a.m. in the morning. There could be a line of big storms rolling across northern Missouri.
Those winds look like they could be damaging.
Could be. That would be the primary hazard, I think.
Right. So this is while we're sleeping.
Nice.
Time to make sure your phone's volume is on. Set those alerts. Make sure that you have a weather radio just in case you lose power or your phone doesn't go off for some reason. You want to make sure you have all kinds of resources tonight.
Indeed.
All right, Jen, back to you.
All right, well, speaking of being prepared, we've got Typhoon Halola barreling through the western Pacific, bringing wind gusts over 75 miles an hour and making a beeline for military members stationed at Kadena Air Base in Okinawa, Japan. Red Cross members are there, and they are ready. So joining us now live via Skype from Okinawa is Joshua Williams, based with the American Red Cross there. Joshua, thanks for joining us. I know you guys are no stranger to this kind of weather, but still always, you know, takes some time to get everything prepared. Tell me what preparations are being done today.
Sure. Currently, the American Red Cross services armed forces on Okinawa. We've been preparing for this all season. Basically, we've been stocking up on supplies, making sure that our service members and their families are prepared with free disaster kits. We've also been offering typhoon preparedness classes as well. We've also been giving them the access to a vital key that we just started recently, is our which is the American Red Cross emergency app, which can be located at redcross.org. Basically, this app allows family members or anyone in a similar situation as this to have step-by-step instructions how to prepare for it and even how to react to it afterwards. And also, Jen, this app actually gives you access to step-by-step first aid instructions as well. So it's a very, very important app.
It's great to have Josh Williams. Thank you so much for joining us. And stay safe there in Okinawa. I have that app, and you know what? It's handy if you lose power, then you still have all the information available to you on your phone. All right, coming up, we've got another sweltering summer weekend for parts of the country. 8 states under heat advisory. We'll show you which areas are expecting the highest temperatures.
Zantac heartburn alert. Stop. Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Brought to you by Zantac.
Hi, I'm Hall of Fame catcher Johnny Bench. Now, I may have retired, but I'm definitely still active. That's why for over 10 years, I've used Blue Emu Super Strength Cream so I can still do the things I love and the things I don't.
It's easy to buy insurance and forget about it, but the more you learn about your coverage, the more gaps you might find.
Like how you thought you were covered for all this, when you're really only covered for this.
Hot dog.
Or how you may think you're covered for this, but not for this.
Oh, no.
Or this. Or this. Or that. Talk to farmers and see what gaps could be hiding in your coverage.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Let's go from clutter to clean. Stop boxing ourselves in. Let's get organized and build a better bathroom. That's it. Let's give it some style with a little polish. Let's put everything where it belongs and put the room back in bathroom. Let's do this. Shop Stylish Vanities in-store and online. The Home Depot. More saving. More doing.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early. Sunday, mostly cloudy, high 88, winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Okay, have you seen this video? If you're just listening in this morning, come over to your screen. This is a woman that's trying to break a window of a car right here, trying to rescue an abandoned child that was left inside a vehicle in Kansas City this last week.
And it was very hot outside. Now, luckily, they got the toddler out in time. But would you know what to do if this happened to you? Well, NBC's Jeff Rossin explains where on the window you hit, it will make a big difference.
Just days ago, this woman desperately hammering on the back window of a stranger's car. inside a two-year-old girl left in her car seat. The temperatures inside soaring well over 100 degrees. Thankfully, the baby was pulled to safety.
The baby's in a car.
Then on Monday, it happened again.
It's 95 degrees.
This time, two children locked inside, rescued just in time. So how hot does it get? I'm climbing inside this car with Miami-Dade Fire Rescue. I'm wearing all these wires so you can monitor my health.
Absolutely.
And right away, I am feeling it.
We're already over 100 degrees inside of this car, and it's only been 3 minutes.
Now imagine a baby in here.
Kids get hotter faster than adults do. So as hot as I am right now, a child would even be in more danger. At least twice.
Just 10 minutes in, my body temperature is spiking.
101. Now you're in a danger zone.
A few minutes later, he takes my temperature again.
Temperature is getting almost to 104. I want to end this. It's too dangerous for you. He called it off because, I mean, look at this. My body temperature got too hot. I'm already at 104. I mean, look at this. A child can't open the door like I just did. That's what sticks with me.
So what if you spot a child in a hot car? How do you break in? You've seen it's not easy. Firefighters showing us how to do it.
My first instinct would be to literally punch this window or elbow it.
Go ahead, give it a try. Hurts, doesn't it?
It won't break.
No, you're not gonna break it. It's gonna hurt you, it's probably gonna break your elbow, and we don't wanna break this window anyways, because if we do, glass shards are gonna go all over your child. We wanna use the other side.
So if your child's over here, go to the other side of the car.
Opposite side of the child.
How do I break this?
Okay, everyday objects. We go to the trunk. We grab a tire, you know, tire iron,
or a
lug wrench, okay. Right? We change our tires with that. It's got a sharp end. Grab the handle.
And by the way, you're telling me this is the weakest part of the window, right? The lower
bottom. Yeah, we don't want to use the center of the window because that's the strongest part. We're going to use the down in the corners. Get that point to where it is, right there in the corner. And then we want to pull back and then go in.
Wow.
Here's another option. You can get a window breaker at any big box store, auto store, something that's cheap, $10 to $15. You can keep it in your car, no problem. Okay? It's got a sharp point. Anybody can use it. You're gonna strike the same spot as I did on the other side, right
okay.
here.
Okay, I'm gonna try. Wow.
Nice and easy.
Look at that, then you just do this.
Yep, and you don't wanna use your hand.
And you can
start at the top, work your way down.
And that's it.
Just that simple, you can save a child's life.
New experts say pets are vulnerable too. Even if you think you're helping by cracking the window, it's not enough. You can still overheat. And unfortunately, just this morning, we got news that a two-year-old has died after being left in a hot car in Arkansas Friday afternoon. Kate, kidsincars.org, it's a great website with useful information. They offer that window breaking tool, $30 donation, and they'll send you two of those tools. I really think it is just important to have in your car.
Really important to have, and important to just know the difference between, even if you're just running into the store for a second, just don't do it. Take the child with you into the air conditioning, especially in Kansas City this week. Average high is 89 degrees. You're going to be getting up to 97 by the time you get to Tuesday. So you're going to see all of your clothes sticking to you. And it's also dangerously hot. I know a lot of folks during the summer, you want to get outside, you want to exercise. But if you have the excessive heat warnings in place like you do in Tulsa or Memphis, you're going to be seeing yourself really strained, and you can cause heat stroke very quickly. We're not just talking about kids here. We're trying to keep you safe too. Now the jet stream, this little bulge that we have in it, this is really what's holding a lot of that heat in place, but we have a lot of humidity to boot. So this isn't dry air. You know, we talk about, you know, the difference between a dry heat and, you know, a more moist heat. Well, this is very humid air, high dew points. It means that you're going to be feeling the air temperatures really amplified. It's going to feel so much hotter out there, and it's going to become more dangerous more quickly.
Yeah, it is. And Kate, by the way, that graphic is my favorite ever. I just want to play with that
this
and slide
so
the temperature and dew point and find out how hot it could be. We'll do more of that, and we'll track the tropics up next.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy. Meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With
the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire. Even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to EverGrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
Unbelievable. Toenail fungus? Seriously?
Smash it with Jublia. Jublia is a prescription medicine proven to treat toenail fungus. Use Jublia as instructed by your doctor.
Look at the footwork.
Most common side effects include ingrown toenail, application site redness, itching, swelling, burning or stinging, blisters, and pain. Smash it.
Make the call and ask your doctor if Jublia is right for you.
New, larger size, now available.
Monday on AMHQ, tracking the return of storms and heat. And as the hard court tennis season picks up, U.S. Open champion Andy Roddick joins us live Monday on AMHQ.
Bahamas Paradise Cruise Line, sailing from the Port of Palm Beach, has exciting cruise rates for Florida residents and visitors on multiple cruise dates, with prices of just $149 for all interior cabins and just $169 for all ocean view cabins. You'll sail on Florida's newest, most flexible, and best Bahamas cruise. Your two-night cruise will include delicious dining, some of the best live shows at sea, lots of fun, lots of pampering, and an exciting day in the Bahamas. If you're looking for a longer vacation, add two or four nights at the all-inclusive, beautiful Grand Lucayan Resort to your cruise. Enjoy spectacular white sand beaches, family fun, fine dining, golf, and so much more. Call 800-814-7100 to book your Bahamas Paradise cruise from just $149 and let the summer vacation fun begin. That's 800-814-7100. 800-814-7100.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 74. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy. High 88. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Weekend, so it's a great time to get outdoors, enjoy some great destinations. How about the Great Smoky Mountains, the most visited of all the national parks? We got some heat going on this weekend, but we should be dry, not looking at a large chance for thunderstorms. So really, it's a great time to visit. If you're doing any hiking, just be ready for the heat and humidity. Temperatures heading up to the low 90s Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Humidity up as well, so lots of extra water if you're doing some hiking or camping. Kate?
Okay, hiking, camping, all wonderful. Not so great, though, at beaches upcoming this week because of what might or might not be brewing.
Yeah, and you know what? Kind of regardless of whether or not we have development, and there's some chance, not a huge chance, 20% according to the Hurricane Center in that swath. But, Kate, you were saying doesn't really matter because right. There's going to be impacts on the coast, and those impacts will be in the form of rip currents, really, because of the potential of a low pressure and a frontal zone and a whole bunch of stuff off the coast. But the rip current threat with that onshore wind is significant.
You know, we oftentimes think that, okay, the rip current risk goes up when we have really large waves, but in fact, most rip current deaths happen with 2 to 3 foot waves. Yep. That's all it takes.
And we'll have a lot of that with this sort of prolonged onshore flow. It won't be real strong. The waves, as you said, won't be real high, but there will be that rip current risk. And so really all the way from Hatteras down through parts of North Florida, stay tuned and be near a lifeguard if you're going to be in the water.
Yeah, this is definitely something that we're trying to really drive home because rip currents cause a lot of deaths every year, and men particularly, Greg.
Yeah, they think they can overcome the water, right? But even Michael Phelps can't swim out of a rip current.
Right. So this is the setup, right?
Yeah, this is the setup we've got. We've got a couple of fronts down here, and we're going to have some storms flare up today and over the next several days at least. And this is part of that whole big soup of stuff going on here across parts of the southeast and just off the coast. And that stuff, those fronts and all that other junk, is going to lead to a lot of rain in Florida. This is another one of the impacts that we're going to be seeing that you need to be aware of if you're in Florida, for example.
A lot of people trying to get that last minute vacation in and determined to get to the beach no matter what. You're saying, hey, slow goes it.
Yeah, slow goes it in Florida. And if you're traveling outside of Florida to parts of the Caribbean, really good news. The weather here is much better. It's much drier. Unfortunately, it's probably too dry. In fact, there is a significant drought across much of this part of the Caribbean. But as far as tropical development here, not going to happen anytime soon.
Okay, so that's good news, but we'll be looking out a little farther coming up in the next couple hours, right?
Indeed, yep.
Okay, coming up after the break, we're going to talk about one couple's Frozen-themed wedding. It's getting a lot of attention, but it's not what you think. The ultimate white wedding when AMHQ weekend returns.
It's a nice day for a white wedding.
Craig, say your name.
Great weekend destinations brought to you by Bush's Beans. What's your favorite flavor?
One can of Bush's Beans.
Well, this is a predicament. Home style sounds good, but country style not without its charms. Brown sugar hickory? Who says no to hickory? Not this guy. New Sweet Heat? Sure. There are no rules here. No rules on aisle 4.
Our new Sweet Heat is cooked according to our secret family recipe with a sweet and spicy chili sauce.
Did you get a can of Bush's Beans?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Bush's Beans. What's your favorite flavor?
Okay, ladies. I wouldn't think. Whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I got this.
Oh, no. I'll get it.
Let me get it.
I don't
want you to pay for this.
It's not happening, honey.
Let her get it. She got a safe driving bonus check from Allstate last week, and it's her treat.
What about a tip?
Oh, here's one. Get an Allstate agent.
Nice.
Switch today and get 2 safe driving bonus checks a year for driving safely only from Allstate. Call 866-788-0900 now.
Ah, here we go. Ah, hold on, man. Is that a leak up there?
That's a drip.
Okay.
Now that's a leak.
That is a leak.
And if you don't have Allstate renter's insurance, game over.
Protect your valuables from things like water damage for as low as $4 a month when you add renter's insurance to your Allstate auto policy. Call 866-788-0900 now. And if you're a safe driver, you can save up to 45%.
Just a few more ways Allstate is changing car insurance for good.
Call a local Allstate agent today.
Why would you need a backpack that's backed by a guarantee? Bean backpacks. Guaranteed for all the things life and kids throw their way. Designed smarter, built tougher.
Huge savings on oil changes are in store this week only at Pep Boys. We're talking $17.99 for a conventional oil change, or upgrade to a Castrol or Pennzoil full synthetic oil change for $39.99 with coupon. Trust the boys to get you there.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
That's why we get real local the moment you need it.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, Mississippi, Florida.
Real accurate.
This is round one of the severe storms that are coming through.
From real experts on the ground.
That is a gust front for you right there in Dusty, Texas. Wow.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel
great. Keep the Weather Channel on.
Here at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
Okay, so you wouldn't typically think of Denali National Park as a wedding destination, but one couple did.
Their story and their wedding album have us all saying it's amazing out there, as our Jen Delgado shows us.
A Washington couple is giving new meaning to destination wedding. Chad and Katie Cochran tied the knot more than 5,000 feet above sea level on Pinca Glacier in Denali National Park.
The mountains are a very special place for both of us. And we just feel the most alive in the mountains, and so we wanted to capture that with our wedding. I asked Chad, I'm just like, what do you think about getting married on the glacier? And his face just lights up, and he goes, yes!
Only 4 names on their guest list. The couple, an ordained mountain guide, and a photographer. For this backcountry wedding, the bride swapped heels for boots, a veil for a hat, and a limo for a plane.
I just wanted to combine like an adventure wedding and kind of a traditional Catholic wedding. Not many people get married on a glacier in Alaska.
A special wedding with one-of-a-kind photos to match.
We didn't fly into the glacier at 7 o'clock. So those photos were actually shot quite late at night. I really like the photo of Katie waving the plane goodbye. When Katie got dropped off in the glacier and the plane took off and left, she knew that she wasn't flying back out on an airplane. She was walking out.
Yep, that's right. There was no plane ride back for the newlyweds. They spent their honeymoon climbing, hiking, and rafting back down the mountains.
The sun never sets, so it was like one big, long wedding day. It was awesome.
That is so cool.
The best story ever.
That is so cool. One long wedding day. I love that. That is so neat. You know, I was up there, and I have to tell you, my sister said, I don't like this vacation. I want one when there's nighttime.
No,
she was about four at the time.
Yeah. Not in the summertime. All right, coming up, we've got some liquid sunshine in Florida. You know what that is.
Oh, yeah, lots of rain.
Leave early. Go roam. Sleep in. Sleep out. Stargaze. Dream big. Wander more. Care less. Beat sunrise. Chase sunset. Do it all on us. Get your first month's payment plus 5 years wear and tear coverage. Make the most of summer with Volvo.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment. I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It's the one and only cure that's one pill, once a day, for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. With Harvoni, there's no interferon, and there are no complex regimens. Tell your doctor if you have other liver or kidney problems or other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Harvoni should not be taken with any medicines containing amiodarone, rifampin, or St. John's wort. It also should not be taken with any other medicine that contains Sovaldi. Side effects may include tiredness and headache.
I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Chance of rain, 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 74. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy. High 88. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Oh my gosh, go.
Hey Larry, we need
go
to go.
Now.
Go,
go,
go.
Terrifying moments for a family attempting to capture a California wildfire on video and almost getting engulfed in the fast-moving flames. You'll hear more from this family about their narrow escape from this fast-moving blaze.
Hey Florida, you're going to be seeing and hearing a lot of this rain this weekend. A look at just how much rain you'll be seeing and what effect it might have on your weekend or vacation plans.
And guess what? We've got a close eye on the tropics and the mystery that may or may not develop. What is it going to do? Help, I can't stop. I can't wait. Stay tuned. It's coming up. We'll talk much more about this area for possible development.
Plus, it's shaping up to be a great weekend for balloons to set go to flight in New Jersey. We're going to talk to the organizer of this annual event and what steps they take to make sure Mother Nature doesn't deflate the fun.
That's a good one, Kate.
Hey, you know, it wasn't me. Thank you, producer. All right, good morning. Welcome to AMHQ Weekend. It is Saturday, July the 25th. I'm Kate Parker. Reynolds Wolf is out, but we've got Jen Carfagno here.
It's good to be here. Good morning, everyone. Of course, we've got Dr. P.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, I know. You know what? We have a lot to talk about, obviously, severe weather-wise, but also in the tropics, there could be something brewing close to home, and we'll talk about that. But Jen and Kate in Florida, we've got a lot of rain.
I mean, so regardless of tropics or not, it's going to feel tropical.
That's right.
Look at all this. This is in St. Augustine. A lot more heavy rain on tap, you know, for both the East Coast and the West Coast of Florida today. But you can tell how quickly it came down in St. Augustine. You can see it washing up there on the steps of this home or home or business. Fortunately, we've been mentioning the fact that we've got really sandy soil here, so long-term flooding not going to be an issue. Short-term flooding, though, in Florida happens really often.
If you're the one trying to get off these steps, it's a problem. I saw some toes trying to get down to the end of there.
What do you do? You need your rain boots.
Yes,
bring
you do.
Bring out the galoshes. Oh, more than galoshes in that video.
Yeah, the boots I think you need. All right, let's talk about today's weather. A quick snapshot across the country shows wet in the south, stormy in parts of the north, and the northwest some changes, too.
Right. It's a little cooler, right, in the Pacific Northwest, but we've got these severe storms today that'll be sweeping across I-70, kind of that corridor, and it's kind of like this setup that we just can't escape this time of year. Don't get storm fatigue. You have another day where you could see damaging winds, and this time it could be your home that's affected.
All right, so we're looking at the heat south of there, too, and, you know, sort of around the bubble of heat will be the storms, and the heat itself will be unrelenting for not just days, but through the week. We've got a lot of heat ahead here, so we'll talk about how high the temperatures get.
Right. Okay, but we've also got a pretty stormy journey through some parts of the south.
Yeah, look at this just ride through Tampa yesterday. Oh, it was a wet one. The windshield wipers going. You know, of course, we've got the video sped up for you. But we had the streets wet pretty much through the day. A lot of the commute in the morning and even in the evening, you had some wet roads to deal with right around the Holiday, Florida area. We're going to be looking for more rain today. We had about 2 inches officially yesterday, but we're going to see more locally, can be higher. You know how it is here. If you get under a thunderstorm in Tampa, you get a downpour. So today we've got some showers already starting to push on shore, and then we keep the forecast for showers and storms right through the afternoon. Temperatures in the low 80s, thanks to all the cloud cover. So at least our heat gets cut a little bit. Let's take a look at what's going on for us right now. On the radar, you can see some showers north of town, north of Clearwater. But at the moment, we are looking at a lot of activity right offshore, and this is where we have some lightning as well. Fort Myers, not so much affecting you in town, but some of the beaches already starting to see these cells pop. See that last one there, that last frame showed a little bit of lightning. Not a good beach day because of that risk for lightning. Very humid out here. It's very typical Florida humidity, and you see it throughout the south and east, but especially where we have that boundary set up across the peninsula, it's going to help enhance the rainfall. So we're going to see additional showers and storms right through today. Tampa, Orlando, Jacksonville, down towards Miami even too. We'll get some rain, which is needed. We have this drought going on, extreme drought across the south eastern portion of Florida, especially. The moderate drought extends up here right along into the Space Coast and the First Coast. To get out of the drought in southeastern Florida, we need more than 18 inches of rain. It's not as hard to do as you think in Florida, but nonetheless, here we're going to start making a dent in that this weekend. Kate.
Okay, so Jen, we've got to go to Tampa now. We're going to talk about where this could be a bullseye for rainfall, at least our computer models indicating that, and what that means for the local area. So let's get the latest on this rain in Florida. Joining us now via Skype, Todd Barron. He's the emergency response meteorologist for the National Weather Service in the Tampa Bay area. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Okay, so we've got a lot of rain in the forecast this weekend. What exactly are you anticipating for Tampa and the surrounding communities?
Well, yesterday we saw some really heavy rainfall around the Holiday area, Clearwater area, and even a little bit further north. They got about 8 inches of rain in some of those localized areas. Today, with that boundary sagging south a little bit, we still have abundant moisture over the area. So we could see aerial averages around 3 to 5 inches over the next couple days. So that is going to cause some localized flooding, especially in those urban and low-lying areas.
Okay, but what would be your primary concern here? Because we know we've got a very sandy type of a soil there in Florida, especially around Tampa Bay. And you start adding in a lot of water to that. It drains fairly quickly, but are there other concerns? Would sinkholes be a problem? What are we talking about here?
In some areas of the state, yes, sinkholes can be an issue, especially whenever it comes to real heavy flooding rainfall. For us, especially here on the west coast of Florida, a lot of urban areas, a lot of roadways that don't drain too well. And even those drainage areas can get clogged up sometimes and create some other issues. But anytime we get a real heavy rainfall event like this, The water does drain well, but the streets do flood fairly quickly.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, Todd Barrow, for gargling over all of those different threats that we could be seeing with this. We appreciate the heads up. Okay. So all this rain in Florida, right? This is going to transition into some tropical uncertainty. It's all part of this very same system. Greg, what is going on?
Kate, thank you very much. Jen, you and I were just talking about this. You know, the whole uncertainty thing, well, everything is uncertain in meteorology, but you have to sort of quantify it. And we got a number here to go with this. How about 20% for that?
So the Hurricane Center finally put their number on. You know, and what it means is we're watching. When you have a front in the southeast over the warm waters this time of year, you got to watch it for potential development.
Yeah, and if something does develop over the next few days in this region, it's probably going to be headed that way toward the east, northeast, or northeast away from the coast. That would be good news. Mm-hmm. But that doesn't mean there are not going to be any impacts. And that's another thing that we are talking about. These fronts hanging out here with this kind of a long shore flow. Let me get a better color for you. So there is actually going to be an onshore component to the wind for quite a bit of the southeast
coast.
Which means
rip current concerns.
Rip currents, exactly. There's going to be one of those kinds of days and weekends where rip currents are a real possibility all the way from, say, the Carolina coast down through North Florida.
And regardless of whether it's tropical in nature or not, there's going to be tropical rain.
Indeed. Yes. And a lot of it in Florida, several inches likely.
Okay, well, more on this, of course, coming up through the morning. And we'll talk heat, too. If you're feeling hot, hot, hot for the weekend ahead, we'll show you where the temperatures will agree with you. We're pushing triple digits.
I'll take it.
Yeah, well, yeah, I'll too, actually.
100 degrees.
Before ISS, before Hubble, we built the most extraordinary machine. Stand nose to nose with Space Shuttle Atlantis, one of thousands of exciting things to explore at Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex in Orlando. Always exploring.
Zantac heartburn alert! Stop! Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Brought to you by Zantac.
It's easy to buy insurance and forget about it. But the more you learn about your coverage, the more gaps you may find. Like how you thought you were covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
But you're not even covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
Or how you may be covered for this, but not for something like this. Talk to farmers and see what gaps could be hiding in your coverage.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Is this really the best way to pick color for a whole room? There's a new way to paint. With the new Project Color app, take any color on a virtual test drive. It's part of the new Color Center experience from the Home Depot. Everything you need to get the right color, right. Let's do this, in hand, online, and at the store. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing. Bear Ultra Interior, just $29.98 a gallon. Download the Project Color app.
Before 3, 2, 1, we built a gateway to the cosmos. Follow in the steps of heroes on the Kennedy Space Center bus tour. One of thousands of exciting things to explore at Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex in Orlando. Always exploring. Real local.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas.
Real accurate.
This affects you.
Real experts.
Wow, that's the leading edge of the thunderstorm.
Only the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 74. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy. High 88. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Monday on AMHQ.
You're about to see something you have never seen on television before.
I want to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
Let's talk about that.
Let's lift the face of this and talk a little bit about tornadoes.
That's pretty impressive.
Let me show you why.
We'll tell you about it coming up.
Can you see that? Look when the lightning strikes. Huge tornado, Roswell, South Dakota. Now, yeah, lightning streaked across the sky, but it was complete darkness until that happened. And when it did, you can see the tornado on the ground. There is no word on injuries or damage at this time. Tornadoes were reported in other parts of the state as well.
I mean, Kate, it's all black, it's all dark until the lightning illuminates that tornado. Wow. All right, so we are watching for the potential of storms with severe weather. There is a small tornado threat. There's a bigger threat for damaging winds across parts of the Midwest and Northern Plains today. So one spot we're watching is Indianapolis. Now, things all good right now, temperatures in the 60s, but we're going to watch later today for that threat of thunderstorms. The I-65 there looks fine for now. We're going to see thunderstorms later tonight, actually. I think into tomorrow is when we're going to look for a better chance of seeing the storms. Most of your day, okay. Indianapolis Indians home, first pitch 7:05 at Victory Field with Louisville in town. I think you'll be okay, but we got to watch how things are going to pan out for later on. It's already busy to start today in Missouri. You can see right now two areas under flash flood warnings, one area under severe thunderstorm warning, potential for some hail with this cell right here, as you can see, right around the Osage Beach area, Iberia, St. Elizabeth, Tuscumbia, all under that warning until 5:30 local time. So watching that, watching other areas with just very tremendous rain that we are tracking, you can see all this big blow up of reds and oranges and yellows on the radar. That indicates where we're seeing some of the heaviest of rain. What you also notice is that this is not moving east very quickly. So coming down in one spot too. Until 8 o'clock, we got a flash flood warning for Cheriton, Macon, and Randolph counties. Again, until 8 o'clock this morning. Saturated ground to begin with, and then we put this heavy rain on top of it. Boundary in place as well, and this is going to be one area that we watch for a focus of more storms to fire later today and into tonight. We've got some strong winds, some jet stream winds up here, which will help enhance that risk for severe weather. In general, as we get into later hours today and even tomorrow, the upper level winds won't be as much of a factor, but they're there. So we've got the front, we've got the winds, we've got plenty of moisture coming back to the area after some very nice low humidity days. That's changing. We got the moisture returning to the region. So let's show you what the future radar thinks things are going to look like later today. We're going to see showers and storms popping into the afternoon. This is 3-4 o'clock. You see in lower Michigan, you see in Indiana. So right after the game in Indianapolis, we got to watch the skies. There could be some showers and storms popping in the area. This is overnight now, though, right along that I-70 corridor, back all the way from Ohio through Indiana, Illinois, and into Missouri. We're thinking another round of storms will be ongoing as we get you into the overnight. Now, for today, the red zone goes from North Platte, Nebraska, Kansas City. You have the risk of thunderstorms today, all the way through Indy and Detroit, even into parts of Ohio. We're talking about Toledo, the risk of thunderstorms. Damaging winds going to be the main risk. Some spotty hail reports are possible as well. Into tomorrow, St. Louis, we bring you back into the mix. The red zone right here, Springfield, Peoria, Columbia, all with the risk of thunderstorms for your Sunday. So heads up here. And then not to mention, Kate, we got a lot of heat to talk about in these spots too.
Boy, do we. Let's go to Kansas City, Missouri, where we do have a heat advisory in effect. Obviously not a lot of traffic on the roads right now, but let's talk about what happens when you go to the K tonight and you go to see the Royals play the Astros. The first pitch is at 7:10. And the temperature's still going to be in the 90s. Now, the K is beautiful, but you get a lot of that sunlight in there. If it's beating down on you, if you're in the upper levels or even part of the lower level, you're really going to feel some of that heat. 94 today, 95 tomorrow, Tuesday, 97 degrees, a full 8 degrees above average. But it's not just the heat, it's the humidity. We've got a lot of moisture. Jen was just talking about this. The soil's saturated, and we've got, you know, a lot of cornfields in this area. I know that sounds very... like an odd thing to bring up, but actually we have a lot of moisture that's released from those, and that makes the dew point even higher, which makes it feel even more, even hotter outside, makes it more dangerous as well. Tulsa, excessive heat warning. Memphis, excessive heat warning. A widespread area of heat advisories in effect. This means you need to change your plans. It's not just the heat that's uncomfortable, it's the heat that is dangerous, especially if your kids playing outside, their little feet on that hot concrete, please be careful. This jet stream bulge, this is what's causing this rise in temperatures, kind of this bubble of heat that's hanging out here, and we also have very high humidity, very high dew points here. But what does that mean, right? We always say high dew points. What does it mean? Double rainbow. Look at these rainbows of temperatures. 82 degrees will be your air temperature at 9 a.m. in Memphis, but your dew point is 76 degrees, which means you're starting out the day feeling like it's 90. You go through the day, you get closer to 3 p.m., your air temperature is only 92, but it feels like 102 thanks to that 73 degree dew point. And then later this evening, you're not getting much relief. You stay like you're feeling around 97 degrees at 9 p.m. It should not feel like 97 degrees at 9 p.m., Jen.
Or any p.m. or any a.m. either, Kate. No, it is going to be oppressive to say the least in a lot of spots and for days. So coming up on AMHQ weekend in the West, crews are bracing for a fresh run of raging wildfires burning across three states, sending tourists and campers fleeing. We will hear from one family escaping as flames closed in on them.
Today we're getting record snowfall.
Radars indicate there's been flooding throughout the area.
We're getting hail the size of golf balls.
Maglite. Turn your light on, America.
Be prepared for weather-related emergencies. Maglite flashlights. Turn your light on, America.
Nice job, guys. And don't worry, this beauty will last and last because I'm the only pain primer in one with easy wash formula, which you may find pretty handy someday.
Olympic One Paint with exclusive easy wash formula stands up to 1,500 scrubs. Olympic, simply done, exclusively at Lowe's. Stop by Lowe's and save $5 per gallon on Olympic paints and stains. Just another way Olympic makes it easy every step of the way.
You totaled your brand new car. Nobody's hurt, but there will still be pain. It comes when your insurance company says they'll only pay 3/4 of what it takes to replace it. What are you supposed to do, drive 3/4 of a car? Now, if you had Liberty Mutual new car replacement, you'd get your whole car back. I guess they don't want you driving around on three wheels. Smart.
With Liberty Mutual new car replacement, we'll replace the full value of your car. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Bop, 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 bop.
Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ, the whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Great time for a shiny floor wax, no? Not if you just put the finishing touches on your latest masterpiece. Timing's important. Comcast Business knows that. That's why you can schedule an installation at a time that works for you, even late at night or on the weekend if that's what you need, because you have enough to worry about. I did not see that coming.
Don't deal with disruptions. Get better internet installed on your schedule. Comcast Business, built for business.
We've been killing date night. We've been focused on apps and hashtags and posts, anything but each other. But tonight, we have this pizza. We delight in the crispness of thin crust, slices of mozzarella, savory basil pesto, and the wholeness of cherry tomatoes. Tonight, we breathe life back into life. New Bon Appetit pizza. Life is delicious.
Monday on AMHQ, tracking the return of storms and heat. And as the hardcourt tennis season picks up, U.S. Open champion Andy Roddick joins us live Monday on AMHQ.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy after midnight, low 74, winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy, high 88, winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Today marks day 5 since a massive wildfire started, and this was in Montana's Glacier National Park, already burning 4,000 acres while chasing campers and tourists out of campsites, with one family right in the thick of it as flames raced near their car.
Yeah, oh my gosh, go.
Okay, Larry, we need
go
to go.
Now. Go
now, go.
Like, yeah, no, no, fast, Dad, go. Holy crap, Dad, go. Shoot, like, freaking go fast. Freaking, oh my gosh, dude, it's like chasing us, go.
You guys, this gives really great perspective. You know, we always see pictures of wildfires from above, that aerial footage. Very rarely do we get to see pictures from what it looks like on the ground. Those flames reaching higher than the treetops, it gives you really good perspective on just how massive this is. Nearly 300 firefighters are battling by air and ground. No containment so far. Coming up later on AMHQ Weekend, we're going to talk live with the family who captured this amazing video while escaping those flames. Let's talk about what's going on. The wildfire risk increasing anytime that we have a drought like we do. And look at this. Back on January 1st, our exceptional drought in California was at 32%. Look how this has changed over the last several months. You can see these darker red areas growing, especially in central California. That's where we've seen a lot of that drought almost deepen. 46% of the state now at exceptional drought. So we've got a tremendous amount of moisture, lack of moisture, and we need a lot to make up for this drought. In fact, how much would it take? Over the course of 6 months, we would need nearly 20 inches of rain in Northern California. Central California, you would need over a foot to a foot and a half. If you're in Southern California, you need more like 4 to 8, 8 to 12 inches, especially right there along the coast. What are the chances that you're going to get it though? Now, some parts in the state have better chances than others. Northern California, you got about a 50-50 shot, but if you're looking at the central portions of the state, 0% chance to 8% chance, very slim chances they are going to see an improvement there the next 3 days, staying dry across California. So, Jen, you know, it's sad because we really want to help improve the conditions there, and we are going to see a pattern set up maybe later this year with El Nino that could improve things a little bit, but a 0% to 8% chance.
I think we're putting a lot of stock in that pattern change.
Yeah.
But it's happened in the past. Has been helped.
We do need to go ahead and just count that we're not going to have it.
Right.
Act as though we won't.
All right. Well, how about though, while we're in the West, let's talk about the Angeles Crest Scenic Byway, which ascends up 66 miles through some of California's most picturesque roads.
Now, the start point is actually just miles from Los Angeles and a great escape from the bustling nature of the big city. Our Maria La Rosa takes us on a tour.
Los Angeles is infamous for its crowded freeways, but just 15 miles from downtown is a beautiful escape from the gridlock of the city.
We're here along Angeles Crest Scenic Byway. It's part of California State Route 2. It's 66 miles long. It takes you through Angeles National Forest, along the beautiful ridges of the San Gabriel Mountains, and it also happens to be one of the highest roads in Southern California. Let's go.
It's probably one of the nicest roads out there. The curves on the road, the beautiful trees, and it's just an absolutely gorgeous drive through here.
Part of the pleasure of this drive is actually taking time to stop and explore the scenic turnouts.
We're at mile marker 38, Red Box Gap, and as you can see from the stunning views, we are up high, more than 4,600 feet, down there, the east and west fork of the San Gabriel River. This area got its name from a red box that, early in the 20th century, firefighters used to store their tools.
What's amazing about the Angeles Crest is the different types of terrain you pass through.
We're here at Islip Saddle, right in between Mount Williamson and Mount Islip, in the center of the San Gabriel Mountains and nearing the peak of our drive. What's interesting, you still have plenty of greenery here, but not too far off in the distance, the barren Mojave Desert.
All along this drive, I've just been surprised to see so much color. I mean, California is in the midst of one of the worst droughts in its history, and yet you have these beautiful yellows and purples.
Just the smells up here are terrific. And we just love to, you know, get out and walk a little bit and smell the flowers.
Far above Los Angeles, the drive reaches dizzying heights.
Well, we've made it to the end of our journey, actually the peak, Dawson Saddle, some 7,900 feet in elevation. It is all downhill from here, but in a good way. Hope you enjoyed the ride.
I did. I want to go.
So neat. Yeah. But what does the forecast look like, right? We've got to get that figured out.
All right. Well, we actually have some pretty good weather in store for us here. So we are going to watch for some comfortable temperatures, driving weather, turn down the window a little bit, a little warm around La Cañada, Flint Ridge, but Wrightwood, 92, 90. But in between, when you get up at elevation, yeah, very comfortable.
Windows down, yeah, hands out the window, feeling the wind. Mm-hmm. Ooh, it sounds good.
Well, you're not having windows down in the Sunshine State. We've got a lot of rain for parts of Florida. In fact, some folks could see up to 8 inches of rain this weekend.
We're going to take a look at that forecast and show you what we're anticipating in the tropics coming up.
See that.
Best Scenic Drives, brought to you by Volvo.
Leave early. Go roam. Sleep in. Sleep out. Stargaze. Dream big. Wander more. Care less. Beat sunrise. Chase sunset. Do it all on us. Get your first month's payment plus 5 years wear and tear coverage. Make the most of summer with Volvo.
Welcome to Fort Greene Sheets.
Welcome to Castle Bravestorm.
It's full of cool stuff like my second in command
and my trusty bow.
And free of stuff I don't like.
And in my castle, we only eat Chex cereal.
Chex cereal.
It's full of delicious crunchability.
No artificial flavors and it's gluten free.
And that's something even my brother,
sister can understand.
Mom, Brian threw a ball in the house.
Scotch Blue Painter's Tape, the one with 3M adhesive technology to resist paint bleed, for clean removal and amazing results the first time. Pull off a better paint job with Scotch Blue Painter's Tape.
One day, a rider made a decision.
I'm ready.
The decision to ride on and save money. He decided to save money by switching his motorcycle insurance to Geico. There's no shame in saving money. Ride on, ride proud. Geico Motorcycle. Great rates for great rides.
Introducing the first ever gummy multivitamin from Centrum. A complete and tasty new way to support your energy, immunity, and metabolism like never before. Centrum Multigummies. See gummies in a whole new light.
Now I know why girls need a sports bra.
Hang out with the people that love you and respect you.
My first feeling was I lost my son. Then I thought, I'm gaining.
Caitlin, she's free. Open, no more secrets.
Love stress.
Mom has that.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 74. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy. High 88. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas.
Real accurate.
This affects you.
Real experts.
Wow, that's the leading edge of the thunderstorm.
Only the Weather Channel.
So this is a perfect example why we say it's amazing out there. We had a really impressive lightning show here in Atlanta last night. I got to tell you, Atlanta being the home to the Weather Channel, you know that you have some serious weather nerds out there.
I love that picture right there. I could watch that all day with some popcorn.
I literally want this in my house. This is how I want to light my rooms with a lamp that looks like this and lights up.
I love the Peleus cloud. You know, it's like the little top hat.
Cap cloud. Yeah. It's like a little hat, a little ball cap.
You couldn't fit the entire cumulonimbus cloud in your house.
She wants a smaller one.
Yeah. Oh, I see. I get it.
I think they make those.
I love how the cloud contains it all. Oh, yeah, we can't keep watching that.
This is what it looks like now. A little different story this morning in Atlanta. 75 degrees from atop the Coca-Cola World Headquarters. Hot day on tap.
A huge chance of storms, really. I mean, that was it in Atlanta, just that one Lone Ranger. A lot of folks in the Southeast will have that kind of situation today. Just, you know, maybe one or two storms and that's it.
That's all you got. Welcome back to AMHQ Weekend. I'm Kate Parker.
And I'm Jen Carfagno, and for Reynolds Wolf this morning. Got Dr. Greg Postel over here joining us as well.
Yeah, you know what? We have some tropics to talk about. Aww. There is the potential for some development, not a huge chance, but the models have been suggesting for a few days that there might be some development off the Southeast coast this upcoming week. Mm-hmm. I would say the odds are maybe 20%. That's what the Hurricane Center is giving it. That sounds about right. And we're going to talk about that. Certainly at about 50 past the hour, tropical update time, at the top of the hour as well.
All right. You know, it's going to be wet in Florida regardless, Kate, right? We got a lot of rain coming.
Yeah, that stalled out little bugger going to be causing a lot of problems as for people that are trying to get in their last weeks of vacation.
Can you believe next week is the last week of summer for a lot of kids in the Southeast? School starts in August.
That took me a little while to get used to have kids go back in the beginning of August, right in the peak of the heat, you know?
Yeah, well, at least they're in AC.
If you're a little farther to the north, if you're living across I-70, you've got a couple more weeks there, but you've also got a few more thunderstorms there, and we could see some damaging winds today, some hail, an isolated tornado.
All right, so tis the season for those northern tier severe storms. We'll track that. We'll track the Northwest, too. We're going to have some cooler temperatures and some clouds in the Northwest.
Okay, well, let's take a look at this. It was slow going for some drivers in Tampa. Look at this. Northern and central parts of the state of Florida, they're going to be hammered by heavy rain this weekend. This is in Pasco County. Oh,
whoa.
A true frog strangler.
Oh, man.
Isn't that great? Okay, this is where floodwaters covered streets and highways. Now, parts of Florida's west coast could get 5 to 8 inches from rain this weekend. And Jen, we were talking about this in the break. You were like, hey, aren't you the meteorologist that works here that's like obsessed with frogs? And I'm obsessed with them and rainfall because they do. The tree frogs will start to do their calls when the pressure lowers. It's all weather connected.
So how did that saying, frog strangling rain, come out? Is it just because...
Because of that guy right there, I think.
Well, do they stop croaking when it rains a lot? I don't know. We got to look this up.
There's a science behind investigation
that Kate's going to lead on that one. All right, but we got rain today. Frogs or not, we got rain for us in Tampa and thunderstorms in the forecast. And starting early, the radar already pretty active. You can see coming in, moving from the north and moving towards the southeast. So showers and some thunderstorms. There is a little bit of lightning up there. There's some lightning down, not too far from Fort Myers either. So let's zoom in. We'll take you to Spring Hill and over towards Hudson and up towards Cedar Key. We got lightning, not a beach day. And really not even a day necessarily to run outside this morning, too, since you do have that risk for lightning. Okay, Fort Myers, this storm had some lightning in it and still has that potential, so I would stay off the beaches down there and down towards Naples as well. You can see the active pattern that we're in. South Florida, Florida Keys, at least the northern Keys, getting some showers. Very hot and humid all across the southeast. Very warm and muggy to start your day. And typical Florida humidity, right? So when you put in a stationary front, which is what we have, it's going to enhance that chance of rain. So we are going to see showers and storms throughout at least the peninsula for sure, and even into parts of the panhandle. Although it's not a huge chance, it's not zero either. So don't be surprised if you see one of those Lone Ranger type storms popping at the end of the day. The spot we need to watch is the peninsula, and you know, we could use the rain. We have the extreme drought across the southeastern portion of the state, West Palm, Fort Lauderdale, Miami Beach, all under that extreme drought. You need more than 18 inches to end the drought in the next 3 months, and believe it or not, it's not that hard to do here in South Florida. When it rains, it pours, and we're looking at that potential in the forecast. Here we go. We put it into motion. Tampa area showers and storms. This is through lunchtime. You can see there'll be more out here throughout the day, right through the afternoon. A lot of the activity moving from west to east, so coming out from the Gulf of Mexico and moving over the Sunshine State. All right, let's talk about another spot that could see severe weather today, guys.
Yeah, we're going a little farther north here along this, you know, seemingly endless ring of thunderstorms in the upper Midwest. I mean, this storm fatigue's real.
Right, and you know, you mentioned this endless ring. This is the ring of fire where the thunderstorms form over the plains at night, typically, and they produce a lot of rain. That's what we've got ongoing right now. And later on today, we'll see more thunderstorms in these locations. North Platte, Kansas City, Omaha, Columbia, your old stomping grounds, St. Louis, Missouri as well, all the way through the Ohio Valley. There is a shot for severe weather. The primary hazards would be hail, high winds, and heavy rain. Chance of a tornado, it's not real high, but you can't ever really rule it out. But what we've got right now, Kate, is more of a heavy rain threat.
Speaking of Como, look at all these different outflow boundaries. They are crazy crisscrossing all over the place across Missouri.
Yeah, those are the sort of cold pools look that are flowing out from the storms. Yeah, right out in here, and then there's some over here. So we've got a lot of little boundaries that are going to be helping to focus thunderstorm development later on today. But but with this stuff that's ongoing now, look at some of these flash flood warnings out. We've got some for Chariton, Macon, and Randolph counties. This is in central Missouri, farther to the south. This one includes Jeff City. So, you know, really, for the next several hours, there's going to be a lot of rain, flooding rain, with look at how much has fallen.
6 inches. And that's only in 6 hours. So you would have to average an inch an hour, which is just mind-boggling.
Yeah, and that's a radar estimate. And there's no reason to think that, based on what we've seen from the reports, that this is, you know, out of the ordinary. So 6.1 inches is certainly in the ballpark for central Missouri in the last 6 hours. I would not be surprised to see quite a few more inches fall down in that very same zone, because these thunderstorms are, you know what, in the last few images, look, they just, like, they almost resurged right in here. See some of those purples and reds showing up there? They're not dying yet. Normally they do this time of day.
Right.
But these guys have some oomph to them. They're a little life. They'll be sliding southeastward.
Okay, we'll be monitoring them.
Yeah, we will. They'll be sort of falling along front over the next couple of hours. There'll be unstable air flowing northward. So we'll see not only these storms, but new ones develop later on today.
Okay, that's our big story. We're really honing in on it, Jen.
And next up, we're going to go look at the sky. It's some great huge balloons floating up there.
This program brought to you by CITGO. Learn about CITGO Coastal Restoration at CITGOCaringForOurCoast.com.
Zantac Heartburn Alert. Stop. Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Brought to you by Zantac.
It's easy to buy insurance and forget about it, but the more you learn about your coverage, the more gaps you might find.
Like how you thought you were covered for all this, when you're really only covered for this.
Hot dog?
Or how you may think you're covered for this, but not for this.
Oh, no.
Or this. Or this. Or that. Talk to Farmers and see what gaps could be hiding in your coverage.
I haven't.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
You're my buddy.
Making the most out of every mile. That's why I got a Subaru Impreza.
Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts, or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
It's an Olive Garden first, but it won't last long. Create your own tour of Italy starting at $12.99. Choose three of our 9 most loved dishes to enjoy on one plate. Serve with salad and breadsticks. Hurry in to create your tour at Olive Garden.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. today, thunderstorms. High 84. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Chance of rain, 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy after midnight. Low 74. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy. High 88. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Good morning to you in Oklahoma City. We got temperatures heating up today. Like it wasn't heating up yesterday, it actually gets worse. 98 degrees. And when you factor in the dew points, it's going to feel like 105. And for hours. And look at tomorrow and Monday, 99. We've got the heat and the humidity lasting right through the weekend.
All right, well, with some awe-inspiring shapes and sizes, the magic of ballooning has arrived just outside of Newark, New Jersey for the 33rd annual Quick Check New Jersey Festival of Ballooning at Solberg Airport. Now, 100 balloons from all over the world are taking flight as 165,000 spectators look to the skies. Howard Freeman is the executive producer and joins us this morning. Good morning to you, Howard.
Good morning, Katie. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty well, but it looks like you've got some activity going on behind you.
Absolutely. That's the hair balloon. Ristorante Italiano is our hair balloon today. We're running a hare and hound. We're the first balloon up. We'll go out about 15 or 20 minutes. We'll lay out a 20-foot X. All the other 100 balloons that we have here will be the hounds. They have to get as close to that X as possible, throw down numbered bean bags, and then they win up to $15,000, depending on who's the closest to the center of the X.
Oh, wow. That sounds like a really fun time this morning, but we're looking at video of some of the balloons. I know that in just looking at this, I easily have two favorites with Darth Vader and Yoda, but what are some of the fan favorites that'll be up there today?
Well, we have balloons from 22 states, 4 countries, and as you said, a galaxy far, far away. So they're going to let the flight be with them. But my personal favorite is the Quick Check Seahorse. It's 120 feet high. That's a 12-story building. It came up from Brazil for this event.
Oh, wow.
Swam up, so it left about 3 months ago.
Oh, wow.
We also have Baby Dino, a giant baby dinosaur hatching out of an egg. We have Baby Blue, which is a whale and a baby on his side, so there seems to be a theme. PNC has a great Salute America, the largest American free-flying flag balloon. We have the unique Photo Panda, and about 10 or 15 special-shaped balloons, which are kind of the superstars of a festival like this, and then about 90 other balloons. We'll have over 1,500 people take balloon rides this weekend.
Oh, wow.
And another 200 take tethered rides.
That is so cool. We are so excited about this. It looks like a really good time. And that ascension this morning, the hare and the hound, that's really neat. So you'll have to let us know how that ends up. Thanks so much for joining us this morning,
Howard. It's all on balloonfestival.com.
Okay, cool. Thank you so much, Howard. Have fun. All right, Jen, back over
to you. All right, that was fantastic. So either you're going out to the Balloon Festival or you're working on some projects at home this weekend. The weekend is here, right? A lot of folks doing DIY projects around the house. We got a quick look at your national forecast. We are going to be watching for the chance for some storms out there across especially portions of the northern plains. We'll see Florida, of course, being pretty wet as well. Sunday's forecast is going to be a wet one for you, too, and some of the same spots and then the heat in the middle.
When the weather is this beautiful, all you want to do is get outside and enjoy it. And Madison, you guys have a terrific space out here. How often do you get out here to use it?
Not as much as we would like to. We recently had it clean, hoping to improve the appearance, but seems like it's taking a beating from the weather. And the edges of the boards are splintering, so it makes us nervous to have our kids out here.
Yeah, absolutely. And that happens over time, particularly when the sun is out beating down on it every day and you get rain and it contracts and expands. It's going to take a beating. But you've done a great job of cleaning it. It looks beautiful. The next step is going to be to seal it.
Like a stain?
Sort of a stain, but not really. A stain would do a good job of protecting this, but what we want to do is go one step further. We're going to put a solid color coating on this called Decover, and what that's going to do is really provide a great coating and seal it completely, so it's going to be perfectly safe for you guys to get out here on.
So it's like paint?
It actually behaves like paint, It goes on with a roller, just like paint does, and it's also a latex product, so it's water-based, it's easy to clean up. And it's actually made to walk on, it's got a slip-resistant finish, and actually covers up to a quarter inch of any gaps or cracks and splinters, things like that. You can even use it on concrete, as a matter of fact.
How long does this take to dry?
Well, you can walk on it after 24 hours, but to fully cure, you need 72 hours.
This looks great, and we don't have to worry about the kids getting splinters anymore.
Right, and you won't have to worry about the deck either because it's coated and protected for years and years to come.
Weekend Project brought to you by The Home Depot. More saving, more doing. That's the power of The Home Depot.
Let's go from clutter to clean. Stop boxing ourselves in. Let's get organized and build a better bathroom. That's it. Let's give it some style with a little polish. Let's put everything where it belongs and put the room back in bathroom. Let's do this. Shop stylish vanities in-store and online. The Home Depot. More saving. More doing.
I went to Ancestry.com, but I thought, I'm not going to make it very far. I knew my parents and my grandparents, and then it happened. I got a leaf. When I clicked on it, I could actually see my grandfather's draft card from World War I and his U.S. Census from 1910 and another member's tree that had my great-grandparents and their parents and everything. And it all started with my first leaf.
Who will you discover at Ancestry.com?
Oh, man. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, oh, Harry. Man.
You gotta do it like this. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, George.
Hey, Jim.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
The only thing that the L.L. Bean Deluxe Book Pack doesn't carry is a high price. Designed smarter, built tougher.
Monday morning, sunscreen's a must for this time of year. Doris Day joining us with the sunscreen 101 you need before you're in the sun. Wake up with Al Monday morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Let DSL slow you down. Get the fastest in-home Wi-Fi from Xfinity. Switch to the X1 Triple Play today. Call or go online.
We've been distracted. We've been focused on apps and hashtags and posts, anything but our friends. But today, we have this pizza. We get back in the moment and delight in the crispness of thin crust, slices of mozzarella, savory basil pesto, and the wholeness of cherry tomatoes. And in having a conversation with our voices in person. Today, we breathe life back into life. New Bon Appetit Pizza. Life is delicious.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms, high 84, winds west-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 80%. Tonight, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy after midnight, low 74, winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy, high 88, winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Okay, so we're 15 minutes past the hour. We've got a lot of people's attention kind of on edge for their upcoming vacations, last couple weeks of summer, or if you just live near the coast, you know you're always on edge during hurricane season. What is this? What?
What is the Bye. What? Yeah, right. Well, you know, there is a chance for some tropical development not too far away from the coast, the United States coastline, in the next few days. Okay. We've been talking about this at the Weather Channel, you and I, right. Kate, and everybody else here, for several days now, and the Hurricane Center saw last night they came out with their 20% chance of development during the next 5 days. Really, the idea is that if anything happens here, it's probably going to be heading in that direction, which will be on off toward the east, northeast, or the northeast, so away from the coast. But still,
Some impacts.
That's exactly right. Let's get to those impacts, because we've got a front down here and maybe some low pressure development, but regardless of the potential for tropical development, we're going to see an onshore wind, Kate, and you know what that means.
When that fetch gets going out of the east, that's when we get that risk of rip currents really pumping up, and it's a lot of times people think, okay, you have to have large waves to have dangerous rip currents. In fact, it's the opposite. Sometimes waves, and when we're at low tide, the rip currents are the most dangerous, most prevalent, and that's when you're most tempted to go in the water.
Right, so if you are thinking about going in the water this weekend, if the weather allows it, try to do it near a lifeguard, because mm-hmm. the rip current threat is real, and it's going to be from the Outer Banks all the way to North Florida. So, and you might think, well, there's no big storm out there and the waves aren't that big, but the risk is there.
Okay, so
stay tuned for that.
But what else do we have going on?
Well, we have with this whole mess of weather that out of which could development take place, we've got some frontal zones and some thunderstorms, because fronts are very good at having thunderstorms with them and creating a little bit of circulation around them. So we're going to see just messy times over the next couple of days across Florida, maybe even South Georgia, in terms of rainfall. And it could be quite a bit of rainfall.
Ooh. Okay, so this is our homegrown tropical situation over the next 5 days, but the possibility slim, not huge impacts here. But what are we looking at, you know, like on a wider scale across the Atlantic?
Yeah, on the sort of bigger picture, we've got really good weather out across parts of the Caribbean. They need the rain here. There's actually a drought in parts of the Caribbean, so no tropical development here anytime soon, nor further out to the west. We've got too much wind shear here in place that's tearing apart those thunderstorm clusters. But Kate, you wanted to get to this picture.
Yes, I did, because you can see how dry that Saharan dust is, and that air layer is so dry. But look at these little bubbas.
This is what I call dry. It is incredibly dry out here at many altitudes, so thunderstorms that try to get going here will evaporate.
Yeah, okay, well that's good news that we don't have to look there. We're gonna look closer to home though. All right, coming up after the break, a couple's Frozen themed wedding, getting a lot of it.
Amore.
Subito.
The all-new Fiat 500X crossover. With 70 standard and available safety features, including options like all-wheel drive and blind spot monitoring, it's eye candy that watches the road.
No!
Why are you deleting these photos?
Because my teeth are yellow.
Why don't you use a whitening toothpaste?
I'm afraid it's bad for my teeth.
Try Crest 3D White.
Crest 3D White Diamond Strong Toothpaste and Rinse. Gently whiten and fortify weak spots. Use together for 2 times stronger enamel. Crest 3D White.
Huge savings on oil changes are in store this week only at Pep Boys. We're talking $17.99 for a conventional oil change. Or upgrade to a Castrol or Pennzoil full synthetic oil change for $39.99 with coupon. Trust the boys to get you there.
Irresistible moments deserve irresistible treats. New from Meow Mix, with real salmon, chicken, or tuna. The only treat cats ask for by name.
What makes Lay's Kitchen different from the rest? We pride ourselves on bold, authentic flavors with the finest ingredients. Our vegetables are farm grown and prepared with the passion they deserve. Tangy peppers unite with the sweetness of tomatoes and onions to create our exquisite mesquite barbecue flavor. The satisfying crunch and rich flavors of Lay's kettle cooked chips. One taste and you're in love.
Beautiful job. I knew you had it in you. And it was easy because of what I have in me. You know, the color-rich technology and all-climate protection package? It penetrates deep for long-lasting protection and beauty. And I'm the only one who's got it.
Olympic Elite, for exceptional beauty and protection that lasts. Olympic, simply done. Exclusively at Lowe's. Stop by Lowe's and save $5 per gallon on Olympic paints and stains. Just another way Olympic makes it easy every step of the way.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
That's why we get real local the moment you need it.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, Mississippi, Florida.
Real accurate.
This is round one of the severe storms that are coming through.
From real experts on the ground.
That is a gust front for you right there in Dusty, Texas. Wow.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel.
Keep the Weather Channel on.
Here at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
Now, you wouldn't naturally think of a Denali National Park wedding as being incredible, but this couple did.
A destination wedding. Their story and their wedding album have us all saying it is amazing out there, as our Jen Delgado shows us.
A Washington couple is giving new meaning to destination wedding. Chad and Katie Cochran tied the knot more than 5,000 feet above sea level on Pika Glacier in Denali National Park.
The mountains are a very special place for both of us, and we just feel the most alive in the mountains, and so we wanted to capture that with our wedding. I asked Chad, I'm just like, what do you think about getting married on the glacier? And his face just lights up, and he goes, yes!
Only four names on their guest list. The couple, an ordained mountain guide, and a photographer. For this backcountry wedding, the bride swapped heels for boots, a veil for a hat, and a limo for a plane.
I just wanted to combine like an adventure wedding and kind of a traditional Catholic wedding. Not many people get married on a glacier in Alaska.
A special wedding with one-of-a-kind photos to match.
We didn't fly into the glacier till 7 o'clock. So those photos were actually shot quite late at night. I really liked the photo of Katie waving the plane goodbye. When Katie got dropped off on the glacier and the plane took off and left, she knew that she wasn't flying back out on an airplane. She was walking out.
Yep, that's right. There was no plane ride back for the newlyweds. They spent their honeymoon climbing, hiking, and rafting back down the mountains.
The sun never sets, so it was like one big, long wedding day. It was awesome.
I love that.
I mean, that's a fantastic story. What a great album they have.
The wedding day that never ended. Yes. Thanks to the sun
yes.
never setting.
Yes. Yes.
Well, the sun, unfortunately, not setting on the dog days of summer yet. They're just arriving.
They're really just arriving, and you're going to be dealing with the heat. We'll tell you how it can affect your emotions.
It's called Mother Nature for a reason. A nurturing spirit lives within every woman. At Mahindra, we strive to brighten the future for girls with a passion for agriculture. So thank you to the mothers and fathers of America for sharing the wonder of God's great outdoors. Today's future farmers are tomorrow's stewards of the land we care for.
The world's number one selling tractor. Visit MahindraUSA.com.
It's pretty incredible that Sonic combined candy with a slush.
Oh, totally, man. So many different candies, so many different flavors. I'm like a kid in a candy store.
All by yourself?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Like your mom's not there or anything?
No, so...
There's no one else?
I mean, this is the proprietor.
This feels like a trap, dude.
What?
This is a trap.
It's a metaphor is what it feels like.
Too good to be true. This is a trap.
Candy meets slush meets awesome. Candy slushes are half price during happy hour. And try one of our delicious Master Blasts. This is how you Sonic.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 84. Chance of rain, 80%. Tonight, skies clearing overnight, low 74. Winds west-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy, high 88. Winds southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook